show you how to sew on a hook and eye. So we've got our hook here, and I'm going to show you how to do a hand sewn eye, or like a grub loop. If you've got a very fitted garment, sometimes you need to do a hook and eye at the top of an invisible zip, just to help you to then do up the zip. It's very difficult otherwise to do the zip up. So I'm going to put the hook on the right hand side of the garment, and to start off I'm going to hide a couple of back stitches just on the inside near where I want to sew the hook. So don't use knots when you're hand sewing. Knots tend to pull through woven fabric, so they're not reliable and they're also fairly bulky. So it's much better just to do two back stitches and then come up where you want to sew the hook on. Okay, and then just line this up at the top. Of course, the bigger the hook, the easier it is to sew on. It's quite hard to hold onto these little tiny hooks. And I just want to position that so that the end of the hook is at center back. It's at the top there, very hard to hold. So we've got these little two round anchor points, and I'm just going to pass the thread. I've doubled the thread up, pass it through three times. And then recheck that, and then I'm going to anchor it down on the other side. So come across to the other side, or the other anchor point. And three little stitches. And then lastly, I don't want that to be flapping around, so I need to place a couple of stitches across the bar, the straight bar as it goes up towards the hook. So I'll just bring that in under there, and just a couple of stitches to hold that down. And then I can take the needle back out to the inside to anchor it again. So just bring it in there. Oops. That I've got all the thread and that's sitting nicely, and then two back tacks, two or three back tacks to anchor that and stop it from unraveling. Okay, so that's our hook. So now, of course, you can't bring the zip up all the way to the top. I've actually stitched this in so that it comes all the way to the top. If you were going to do the hook and eye, you would finish the zip a little lower and then have the hook and eye at the top. So now I want to come in on the other side to make the hand-sewn grub loop, or grub eye. Trying to decide what you would call this. It's like a grub stitch. So I'm just going to go in here and anchor it. So two back tacks. One, two, just in the seam allowance there. And then bring your needle up to the outside. This time I need to get very close to that outside edge because the grub stitch actually has to come out from center back, or from the zipper teeth. So, and now I want to commence to make the grub stitch. So the way I do that is, I come back in, I'm just going to do one stitch just to anchor it, and then I'm going to bring the needle through and form a loop with the thread. Now while I'm working this grub stitch, I'm going to anchor my work under the presser foot, just so it's held there, and then I can just concentrate on working with the thread. So I've got a loop and I've got the needle and the thread here. So all you do is, with your other hand that's not holding the needle, put it through the loop of thread and pull on the straight thread, and then work that down. And you can do this quite quickly. And the other thing you can do, if you're wanting it to be a bit more, a bit thicker, you can actually put two threads through the needle and have, you know, a total of four threads at a time. So just continue on until you probably have about a centimetre of grub stitch work there. And then on the last one, you pass the needle through the loop and pull it off tight, and that stops it from unravelling. Before you do that locking stitch, if you were to pull on the thread, it would just all unravel. And then I just want to bring this down to make the little loop. So I'm just going to bring that in here. Really working your fine motor skills doing this hand needle work. And I'm just going to do one stitch to lock it off, and then I'm going to pass the thread underneath again and do my back tacks. I'll get that out from there. Pass it underneath and do my back tacks in the seam allowance underneath too. It just hides it so you don't have a lot of ugly stitches showing. And just two back tacks in there, two or three. To hold it and stop it from pulling out. And there I have my little loop, my little grub stitch loop, which I can then hook through, and that's a nice neat way to finish that. It's a much nicer way on at the top of a skirt or a dress than actually using the metal hook that comes with the hook and eye.